All right, all right. It's your man, Jimmy Chan here. Today we're talking about linear inequalities. So let's look at linear inequalities. Let's first look at just inequalities, but everything that you've learned so far has been linear inequalities. So back in high school, you guys talked about like using open circles. Oh, actually, you know what? Let's go this route. You guys used your symbols less than or greater than. And you guys also use the symbol as less than or equal to versus greater than or equal to, right? And with those, when you were graphing them, you use open circle versus a closed circle. All right? Where today, in college, we're actually going to associate open circles with parentheses and closed circles with square brackets. And remember that open circles are kind of like you're not touching it. You can't physically touch it and it's not included. Where the closed circle means included because I can touch it. So that's why a square bracket. Parentheses, you can't touch it, like infinity or a negative infinity, or it's not included, all right? So hence the less than or the greater than sign. All right, so you're gonna have to be able to, you might be given like an example like this, parentheses 5, 8. Nope. Okay, so if you were to graph this, well, how about if I do it this way? Let's say back in high school, this would mean that 5 is less than, oops, I even said just less than x, which is less than or equal to 8. So the way you would graph it would be, here's 5, here's 8. With attached to the 5 is a less than, so we're gonna do an open circle. Attached with the 8 is a less than or equal to, so we're gonna close a circle. And then we will draw a line between those two. And voila. That would be, that's better. And that would be my graph. All right. So what are we going to do now? Now what we're going to do as a graph is going to be this. So 5. 8. So instead of open circle, we're going to use parentheses. Instead of the closed circle, we're going to use the square bracket and then draw a line between those two. Okay? So up here, this right here is called the interval notation. Obviously, the two things that we just did right here would be your graph, right? However, if you look at this part right here, this is gonna be somewhat the same, okay? So we can get that, great. Now we just need to make it a set builder notation, which means x such that the x is between 5 and 8, including 8 but not including 5. So this is called the set builder notation. Okay, so you're gonna need to know how to do all three things because they're gonna ask specifically to give those things as the answer. So you're gonna need to know that, okay? And I feel like I need to shrink this a little bit. Here we go. That's much better. All right. So what else do we need to know? I wanted to talk about unions versus intersect. Okay. Union, if you want to know like how to identify when they're talking about unions versus intersects, unions, they usually use the word or, while intersects, they use the word and. Okay. So what's the difference? Well, unions are everything combined together. Okay. So in other words, if we were to, like, I won't say we, but if I was to get married to a lovely lady, and once we say yes to each other, that means that all of my baggage and all of her baggage will be included in this marriage, all right? In this union, right? So once we say yes, the good, bad, and ugly is all in there. That means I'm committing to whatever she is bringing with her, right? So, you know, whatever debt she has is now my debt, and whatever debt I have is also her debt. Whatever my non-riches is her non-riches, and whatever her non-riches would be my non-riches, right? So that would be a union. So that's why it's combined together. So there's a lot more stuff, right? Because if we're moving into a house, that means everything from my house goes into the house. Everything from her house goes into that house as well. So there's going to be a lot more stuff, right? Where intersect is more of what's in common. Okay. So for example, if we move in together and she has a laundry basket and I have a laundry basket. Awesome. We both have a laundry basket. We have that in common, right? I can make her laugh. She can make me laugh. We have that in common. Awesome, right? She has a laptop. I have a laptop. That's in common, right? But if I have a MacBook Pro and she has a PC, now that's not in common, but that's part of the union, but not part of the intersect, okay? So the intersect, we're going to have a lot less intersects than we would have in unions, okay? So that's what I want to explain to you. So for example, so you might get a problem looking like this, and I'll keep this separated. So I'll just put that example out here. Let's say I got, why did I put those in parentheses? Well, we'll make one of those square brackets. So 6, 5, let's go square bracket. And let's union that with -2, 8 square bracket, okay? And we'll compare that to if we did it this way. So if you notice that the symbol is different as well, right? So union is looks like a U, where intersects looks like an upside down U, okay? All right, so let's take a look at this. Gotcha. I think that's a good idea. So I'm gonna make a number line for both. And what we have here in numbers is, if I look at it correctly, I'm gonna have a -6 and an 8 as the biggest. So let's say I have a 5 and a -2. Okay, so -6, -2, 5, and 8. Okay, so that part is all the same. All right, so let me see how I want to do this here. I'm gonna do this. I like that. Let's do blue. Let's make it smaller. All right, so I'm gonna do the first ones in blue. All right, so if that's the case, open circle at the 6, right? So I'm gonna do it old school style, right? So let's say I have an open circle at 6, a closed circle at 5. Actually, let me see if the smaller marker works better. So open circle at 6, close circle at 5. All right, and then we have a line in between. While we have this one here, oops, let's make it, you know what? So we got that. So we're gonna do these ones in pink, all right? So now let me go back to that small little teeny tiny thing. So the -2 is gonna be open circle, while the 8 is gonna be a closed circle. And then what we're gonna have is a line between. All right, so let's do that here also. Open circle, closed circle, line between. Let's see if I can do this instead. Yeah. And then, the other one was an open circle here, closed circle here, and a line in between. Okay? All right. So, when we look at the union, that means everything is together, right? It's the blue plus the pink. All right, it's all together. So in this case, you're gonna have everything that's not in common with everything that is in common. Because this is a marriage, so therefore everything is together. While over here with intersect, it's what is in common. Right? So if you notice that where the color overlays is kind of purple, correct? So we want to look at the pink open circle here. Notice that there is blue in there, right? The purple doesn't really start until after that -2 open circle. Excuse me. So that means this intersect is going to be an open circle at 2 with a closed circle at 5, because if you look through 5, 5 is purple all the way through. Where the pink circle is only purple after the open circle, okay? So that's why that's still an open circle with a line through it this way. So if you notice, so when we talk about this, our answer, needs to be over here is going to be a parentheses at 6, -6, and goes to 8, close parentheses, when we union those two intervals. When we intersect these two intervals, then we're gonna have a open circle at -2 to 5 and a closed circle at 5, okay? So those would be our so-called answers. So you're going to be given two intervals and be asked to union them or to intersect them. And then you'll come up with a single interval. All right. So next thing, actually talk about inequalities. So you're actually going to actually solve inequalities, right? So the only thing about solving inequalities is that there is one thing to remember. And the thing to remember is when you multiply or divide by a negative. You need to switch the inequality. Okay? So that is very, 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 very important. Okay? So that is only when you multiply or divide by a negative. All right? It's not saying anything about it being a negative. Right? If the result is a negative, doesn't mean you gotta flip it. But only if you multiply or divide by a negative, then you have to switch the inequality. Okay? So let's do an example here. So let's say I have 9 minus parentheses x plus 7 is greater than or equal to 8 minus 3x. So yes, with that parentheses, there's a negative in front of it. So yes, I do have to distribute that negative through. So I have 9 minus x minus 7 is greater than or equal to 8 minus 3x. All right. In the sake of this issue here, I'm going to go ahead and do this problem a certain way, all right? Actually, you know what? Well, let me combine like terms first. So let me see here. I got negative x plus 2 is greater than or equal to 8 minus 3x. I'm gonna write this out. Well, yeah, I'm gonna write it out twice. And the reason why I'm doing that is to show you why I would have to do that. And essentially, I could avoid this whole issue here, okay? And I'm gonna show you right now. So typically, most of you guys want to get the x onto the left side, which is fine, okay? Which is fine. So that means I'm gonna add 3x to both sides. I'm gonna focus on the left side here. So, I'm sorry, the left method here. So you know what I should do? I should say, all right, so I'm gonna focus on method one right now. I'm gonna add the 3x to the left side. So I'm gonna have a 2x plus 2 is greater than or equal to 8. Subtract 2, so I got 2x is greater than or equal to 6. So x is gonna be greater than or equal to 3, okay? I didn't multiply or divide by a negative, so I don't have to flip the inequality. On the right here, the method two, let's say for just the sake of using this rule here, I'm going to add the 1x over to the right side. That means I gotta subtract the 8 over to the other. And I have to divide by negative 2, okay? Because I divided by a negative 2, I want you to see something here. Notice what happened, okay? All right, because I divide by negative. Now let's look at the result of the two methods here, all right? So remember back in grade school, they were like, oh, this is like a fish. It's the mouth that's eating the bigger number, right? So if you look at the method one over here, the mouth is actually eating the x. While the method two here, the mouth is still eating the x. So essentially, these two inequalities mean exactly the same thing. So if you're wondering if you can, you know, kind of flip the X over to the left side, yes, you can. It would just literally be the mirror image of it. So if you notice, the mouth is still eating the X on either method, okay? So with this being said, the way I would graph this, would be, here's my 3, right? It's gonna be a closed circle, and it's greater than, so I'm gonna point it to the right, correct? So that means interval notation would be a square bracket, 3, comma, positive infinity, and closed circle. I mean, not closed circle. It's going to infinity, so that's why it's a parentheses, all right? Now, the last thing I wanna talk about is compound inequalities. So you might have something like -9 is less than or equal to x minus 2, which is less than 6, okay? With this case, you can do it two ways. You can either do it this way where you have to, whatever you add to one, you have to do to the other. So now I got -7 is less than or equal to x less than 8. And now I can go from there. Or you can separate this into two separate equations. So you could be -9 is less than or equal to x minus 2, while the other equation is x minus 2 is less than 6. And then you can solve it that way as well. So over here you would say, okay, I'm gonna add 2 to both sides. So now I got -7 is less than or equal to x, which is the same as x is greater than or equal to -7, because the mouth has to eat the bigger number. Where over here you have add 2 to both sides, so you got x is less than 8, right? So either way you do it, when you graph it, it's still gonna come out to be the same, all right? And you're like, how? These symbols don't even look the same. So let's take a look at that. Actually, before I do that, let's go ahead and do it this way. Let me point this right here, right? So I got the -7, I got the 8. So this is gonna be a square bracket because of the less than or equal to sign, while here we got the parentheses here, and then I would draw the line, okay? So that's great. However, over here, let me still draw another line here. All right, so I got the -7 and the 8, all right? So the one on the left says everything is greater than 7 or equal to 7. So therefore, this is gonna tell me square bracket, and I'm gonna point everything to the right. While the blue is gonna tell me, hey, I have x is less than 8, so that would be a parentheses at 8, but point it to the left, right? So if you look at that, what is the intersect? The intersect would be right there and right there. So if you look at these two, they're the same exact graphs, right? So that's why they're both going to be the same result as is. So over here, the answer is going to be a square bracket, -7, 8, parentheses. All right. Hopefully that answers your questions. If there's any questions, let me know.